Good morning. I'm looking for agent. I'm looking for a publicist. I'm looking for a producer. I am somebody that if I were represented and produced would be the most popular personality on the planet. It's easy to explain why and how. The how is easy. It's really easy. I am censored by the government, by every government, by everyone, everywhere. So nobody wants me to be heard. So I mean, my YouTube account has been shadow banned since 2012. My two or three YouTube accounts have been shadow banned since 2012. Shadow ban, visibility filter, whatever you want to say. So zero possibility of reach other than what I do, forcing past other censorship, my emails, my reader supported news, my Yahoo contributors network. Let's see, YouTube, I've tried Facebook a number of times, of course Twitter. I finally tried Twitter when Musk announced he was going to buy it. I sent one tweet and replied to five others and subsequently could not use my account anymore since May, about a week after the announcement was made. So I got to use my account for a couple of days. I actually think it was maybe one day. So someone is actively preventing me from being heard. Not only that, but they're actually preventing me from being heard by way of my email. They block my emails. They block my Craigslist. I can't put Craigslist ads up. People can't respond to them. I can't respond to Craigslist ads. Let's see. Even so far as I've tried to reach the UNHCR, I don't know if they just ignore me or my emails don't get there, but I tried to email them in 43 countries. And then finally gave up and spent $25 and called the UNHCR in Geneva and talked to the director of refugees for director for Latin America, for Mexico. And she promised me that someone would come and see me in 2 weeks, despite everything I told her about what was going on, about me being blacklisted, all this other stuff. So for these things to happen, there is a lot of very significant global coordination by the establishment to prevent me from being heard. Despite this, I am still heard. People still hear me. People still hear from me. Oh, and these efforts, they extend into the real world too. I'm not just a digital refugee. I'm an actual refugee. I am an actual refugee trying to seek refuge here in Mexico. And as you can see in the background, I don't live in a home, in a house. This is a boat. This is the top story of my boat. Yeah, it's my dog. So I don't live the normal life that anybody else is supposed to live. So, you know, as far as, you know, that a reason for why I should be heard, you know, despite living on a boat down in Mexico, seeking refuge, being harassed by the government, being aware of just how deep this harassment goes and the nature of it and the source of it, despite all this, I'm still alive and I'm still getting the word out. You know, here you are watching this, you know. So far as, you know, why, specifically, why don't they want me heard? Well, it's really easy. I'm very intelligent. I'm possibly the most intelligent person on the planet. I know I'm the smartest. You know, gee, you're all so dumb and immature, you know. No offense, but everybody's stupid. Everybody's immature to me, you know. I've never actually met anyone more intelligent than myself. I'm serious. You know, you have that feeling if someone's more intelligent or not? Yeah, well, I've never felt that about someone else around me being more intelligent. I thought I did a couple of times, but I realized they weren't so intelligent. You know, thought that about my father until I was six, about my mother until I was five. So, you know, I'm freaking smart. So, what is it that I have to say that they don't want me to say? Well, whatever I say, actually, anything I say. Why? Because I'm right. So, you know, market that, you know. If you can't market, if you can't get word out and find something to do with someone who is the most intelligent and smartest person on the planet, who is so good at what he does, who has something to say that is so important that everyone in the world, the governments of the world, everyone everywhere in any kind of establishment, doesn't want him to be heard. Oh, I didn't mention my Telegram and my other efforts to communicate online. Every Telegram channel I have on every, and all my friends too. All my friends are blocked and prevented from their back end. I didn't bet you'd even know you could do back end blacklisting on Telegram. Well, yeah, it's done. I've known about it since 2013. You know, I knew about the Edward Snowden stuff from a year before he did. So I also happen to know that he's a spy for the U.S. He's still a CIA asset. High profile, and the CIA arrogantly believes that the FBI, the KSB doesn't know this, or the FSB, sorry. So yeah, whatever. Anyway, what do I have to say? Well, I have to say a lot, because I am an outsider from in society. I am a wolf in a human body. I'm a wild human in a domesticated human world. I am awake and aware of absolutely everything. I understand what's going on, even our universe, better than science does. I even understand how bad science is. I even understand who controls what I'm trying to get some access to, which is media. I understand it all. And I understand very well why they hate me. So, what I have to say? Absolutely important. People want to hear it. If people want to hear it so bad, the government wants to shut it down so bad, then only problem is me and the mediums. So there's the control of the medium by the people who have the hatred for me, that don't want me to be heard, and there's my inability to bypass that or to go through that. For one, because of my disabilities, I'm brain damaged, suffered from, you know, lack of personality. So, you know, so I don't have an online personality. I don't have a quote-unquote personality. There's just me. It's just raw me. Strip the fucking clothes away, the makeup, the fucking costume, all that shit, and there I am. I also have a costume I can put on, so but, there's that bonus. So what stands between me and being the most popular person out there is the will by the establishment to allow me to speak, or you asserting that will, or changing that will, or convincing them that I should be heard. You're in the background, so that's my line producer. Hopefully. Anyway, so you're watching this video, it's unproduced, it's raw, it's me, it's myself. I am my own producer, I am my own everything. I write, I do everything. I'm what I call a sit-down comedian, which is improvised comedy that you don't have an audience, you sit down in front of a camera and you say comedy. You know, that's sit-down comedy. I'm a sit-down comedian. You know, I do it improv, I do it off the top of my head, which is broken. So it comes out broken. So I do all this without script. I do all this without production. I do all this without any kind of equipment, without any kind of promotion. And yet I'm still heard, because people want to hear what I have to say. Why? Because people need to hear what I have to say. I have it all figured out. I'm awake and aware. Now, why don't they want me to say this? Well, I understand that, because everybody's not capable of being awake and aware. They can't handle it. I don't have an agenda that includes what they fear. My agenda isn't what they fear, which is me telling the truth to everybody. I don't give a fuck about everybody. Everybody's fucking stupid. My agenda? Very simple. I want to find people like me and get the fuck out. That's it. That's all I care about. So, you know, I'll fucking sign on a contract with the fucking U.S. government, or whoever, that says, you know, they can control my content as long as they don't fucking prevent me from finding people I like, finding people that want to fucking leave. Oh, and guess what? These people that I want to find and take with me, they're the kind of people that the government is doing the same thing to me they're doing. So all I'm trying to do is find the other people that they won't let me find. So there's two ways of doing this. I find an agent, and I get out there, and I get public, and I get my word out somehow, some way. And we work contracts, or we fight back and forth, and I end up getting popular, and there's nothing you can do about it. Or, just fucking let me do it. Just put me in direct contact with them. That's the other way to easily do it. But, you know, I'm not talking to those people. I'm talking to fucking people that can actually promote me and make money off me. Because I want to do it that way. I want to make money. I want to make lots and lots of fucking money. I should be heard. Everybody here wants to hear what I have to say. Everybody needs to hear what I have to say. So I'm going to fucking make money saying it. Absolutely. And I'm going to take that money. I'm going to take over the fucking world afterwards. I'm going to start a company called End of the World Enterprises. And I'm going to absolutely take over the economic world. Because it's the end of society, and I understand this. It's the end of all things. People are you know, society is changing its form to accommodate less population. So I'm gonna take advantage of that. So anyway, let's get fucking rich. Produce me, represent me, publicize me, promote me, sponsor me, fund me.